I'm Kelly Leahy with the Software Business Group at Xerox, here to answer your top questions about building workflows in FreeFlow Core. Today I'm going to show you how to handle all of your business cards, whether they're landscape or portrait, single-sided or duplex, bleed or no bleed, in a single workflow with a cut and stack layout. Let's get started.
We're going to go to the Workflow Setup tab and go ahead and add a new workflow by clicking the green plus button. So I'm going to call this All Business Cards 8 Up on 8.5 by 11 Cut and Stack. And like many of the first steps that we have in a lot of our workflows, we're going to go ahead and bring in a preflight. So in this case, I'm going to go and grab one of my presets. I have a preflight preset that does a basic check for fonts not embedded and image and grayscale resolution. You probably also have a list of presets that you've been working with as well for preflight. So bring in whatever makes the most sense based on your workflow needs. The next step here is going to be to normalize the orientation of our business cards. So if we're doing a cut and stack and we have portrait and landscape cards coming in together, we are going to go ahead and make everything landscape. And in order to do that, we're going to go down to our rotate pages component, and we'll do this from scratch. So we're going to drag in a brand new rotate pages and go in here and edit it. Now, if you think about it, when you have a two-sided business card, if you rotate the front to the left, then you're going to have to rotate the back to the right 90 degrees in order to keep the head-to-head registration. So what we're going to do first is we're going to name this preset Rotate Portrait Odd Pages Left 90. And we're going to choose rotate 90 degrees to the left. And we're going to go ahead and say all pages of portrait orientation and just odd. And we'll save that. And then we're going to drag in another brand new one so that we can rotate the back side of the sheet. So same idea here. We're going to say rotate portrait even pages right 90. So rotate 90 degrees to the right. All pages portrait. This time we're going to choose even. And we're going to save that. So now by the time any business card that's portrait or landscape hits this last step in the workflow, all business cards will be landscape orientation. So the next step that we would need to do is if we had a simplex business card that was coming in, we would want to add a back page or pad a blank page to it so that all of our business cards now become duplex. So the next step to be able to do that is we're going to go ahead and bring in an insert page. And by the way, rotate pages and insert pages are part of advanced prepress module. So we'll drag that in. We're going to go ahead and edit that. And we're going to name this Make Duplex, right? Because we want to take our simplex business cards and make them duplex. So I'm going to name this Make Duplex. So the type of page is a blank fill, right? Because we want to add a blank. And instead of being a specific insert page size, we want to insert it the same as the crop box to account for the business card size. If we keep scrolling down, we want to make the final page count a multiple of 2 because we want it to now be a two-sided business card. And the location of that insert is going to be after each last page. So in order to do that, we'll say the location is after each page but that specific page is negative one. So that's after the first single-sided page. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and save that. So now in our workflow, we're doing a basic pre-flight check. We're normalizing the business cards to landscape. So any portrait business card coming in is going to become landscape. And then for any simplex business cards that are coming in, we're padding or adding a blank insert to the back page. So we now have all of our business cards are landscape and they'll all be duplex. So now in order to accommodate business cards that might have come in without a trim box, we're gonna go ahead and bring in a resize pages into our workflow. And we're gonna go in here and edit it. And so we're gonna say add trim box. What we wanna do here is resize the trim box. And we wanna resize it to a specific size, which is our business cards. And after they're trimmed, right, they would be, a landscape business card would be 3.5. by 2. And content scaling, we don't want to have any scaling at all whatsoever for this trim box, so we will simply say none and save the workflow. The next step is going to be to join our, you know, 8 submissions of business cards together to create one PDF. So we'll go here, we'll scroll down, we're gonna bring in a join, and this specific component doesn't have anything that you have to configure. It will simply take multiple single PDFs and combine them into one PDF. So in this case, we're gonna be submitting 8 business card files to this workflow that we're creating, and out of that will come one PDF that was all joined together. And so the next step is going to be to do our imposition. So let's bring this in, the imposition. We're going to configure this again. So now we're ready to test our workflow, but the first thing that we want to do is go ahead and save it. Then once it's saved, I've got some files on the desktop that would represent several business cards that came in throughout the day. And if we take a quick look at them, I'll just open a few. We have a mixture of landscape and duplex, bleed and no bleed, simplex and duplex pages. And we're gonna submit all of these to Core using one workflow that we built. So I'll just close this down. Just pay attention here, all different sizes that came in. Okay, so let me just close this. And I'll go back into Core and I'm gonna submit job. And I can literally just select all of these, drag them right into the FreeFlow Core window. They've all processed. And we want to make sure that this box is checked. So this is what is allowing our join step to take place in the workflow, where it's going to take all of these individual 8 PDFs that were submitted and create a single PDF. Make sure you've selected the appropriate workflow destination that we've built and submit the job. So you see that the jobs come into the active jobs window. We can refresh this to see if it updates, and it looks like it's completed. And if we drop down the little caret, we will notice that we only have one PDF that we've processed now, which is the combination of the 8 individual PDFs. And if we open that, we'll now see our 8 up, cut and stack, with all of our business cards normalized to landscape, a mixture of bleed and no bleed,
And we also, if you remember, added the step to create a trim box if none was available. And I can show you both pages here, front and back. Okay, so here's our Simplex cards that we added the blank backs to. And if you notice, when viewing the 8-up layout, we have a mixture, like I shared, of the bleed and no bleed, but all of the jobs are properly aligned on the trims. So this will make your finishing team very happy when they go to cut these multiple business cards down. So as a reminder, all of that was achieved with the one workflow that we've built. Now you can use this over and over again. Hook this to your web to print order system so jobs can seamlessly flow into FreeFlow Core, and you are one step further on your automation journey.
So I'm gonna quickly submit a couple of jobs to our workflow, and to do that I'm gonna go up to the job management status window and hit submit job. And a quick tip in Core is to make sure that you select your workflow destination before you upload your files, because sometimes you'll tend to hit submit and send it to the wrong workflow. So I always like to come into the workflow destination or set up the workflow destination first, and then go ahead and either add my documents, or you can simply just drop and drag documents in here. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at, we're going to submit some typical business cards. So if I go over to my desktop, in this folder I have four business cards that we're going to submit to this workflow. And if we just open them up quickly, you'll see that we actually have four typical business cards, a mixture of landscape, portrait, bleed, and no bleed. This one here actually is single-sided, but the others are all duplex, okay? And also, they're all about the same size. There's a couple of nuances. This one is 3.75 by 2.25 because that has the full bleed. This one's a little bit different sized. So again, this workflow is going to be able to handle all of these scenarios. So if I close this window, we're going to submit these jobs to the workflow. Just by dragging these files into our FreeFlow Core system. Okay, you'll see that they all came in. We're gonna make sure that we've selected our workflow, and we're gonna go ahead and hit submit. Right away, you'll see that the job has come into Core and that it's processing. I'm gonna go ahead and hit refresh because they probably are done. And they've moved most likely to completed jobs. Yep, and here they are. So we have four jobs. They were submitted as a group, so they have the same job ID. Okay. And in order to see the workflow after it processed through our imposition, we go over to the information tab, and in job properties, we're able to see the completed PDFs. So here's our first business card. Let me make that a little bit bigger. So on 12 by 18, we have our Simplex card, landscape format. Okay. We have our quarter inch gutter and margins that we put in. Our second business card landscape. This is a full bleed doc. You can see that the cards abutted on the trim box. And here's another card. And our very last business card. Also portrait layout, two-sided. Okay. So, again, one workflow, four different files, all automatic imposition, and up on 12x18.
Find out how FreeFlow Core can solve your business challenges by scheduling a live demo with my team at www.xerox.com/automate. Thanks for watching.